Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm continuing with the series of videos I'm uploading about LangChain. I will talk about the integration of LangChain with graph databases. We will speak about a specific graph database just for this introduction. I will show you how to install the graph database. And later we will speak about a little bit in general the graph databases, but together we will be focusing Neo4j. One of the probably the most known or widely known graph database is quite widely used, and they had a collaboration that with LangChain that is a win-win situation, because we can take about advantage of all the advantages that have these two fantastic technologies. I give you some of the links as usual. Today I'm working on local because I also install in local the Neo4j desktop, and I will also show you how to install the sandbox if you want to work with all the functionalities. Everything is for free as well as usual. There is other options, but we will not cover them because I want to focus in how to install it, first of all, the technology. Later on we will cover much more functions of the Neo4j, or specifically Neo4j, because it's more than what we can do with the LangChain integration. And I will cover all these functionalities and the plugins available in Neo4j in a series of videos I'm preparing. So there is different graph databases that integrate with LangChain. Well, you see here there is Amazon, Neptune, Kudzu, ONText, TypeGraph, MemGraph, and Neo4j. Neo4j probably is the most known, is widely used, is on the market for approximately 10 years, is quite mature, and well, is broadly used in four different use cases. And well, again, it's a technology that you probably meet, or you have already some knowledge, and again, quite mature already in the market. And broadly used. There is a collaboration, is an integration with LangChain, and you can use it directly, importing some libraries and use it directly from LangChain. We will cover today how to install it, and we will cover as well a little bit how to use it on with Neo4j. But today, we will just scratch the surface of what we can do with Neo4j, because it's quite extensive the integration in between both technologies. I already upload in the channel different videos using Neo4j for document summarization, for embeddings. Again, this is more than a vector database. A graph database is far away more than a vector database, because well, you can define more a more granular and also detailed relation in between not only nodes. You can also define attributes and relationships in between different nodes, and there is also, as you will see today, different plugins that you can use together with the graph database. The graph database is just a technology. You can make a simile of a graph database like a database, but with some specific attributes or features to you define or model relations in between specific tables. No, you can say tables like nodes, like in a conventional tabular database, the nodes are records in a table, but you can define as well here relations in between what they say nodes. A relation is something that is giving you some other metadata and information about how a table is connected with another table, and you can also apply some other metadata and attributes to those relations. We will look at this a little bit later on, once we have the database installed, and you will see what I'm talking about. So first of all, we will go to the as usual, I'm providing you the all the context links to you install the Neo4j LangChain integration. Well, LangChain, you just need to install the Python connection, the Python client to Neo4j. Neo4j, you had two options, at least for free. Neo4j desktop, but is, I will show you both, and the sandbox. Sandbox usually is a free install, SaaS, is a software as a service, or platform as a service, or whatever you want to say. And then you have there a full operative graph database on the cloud available for 3 to 10 days. I prefer to install it with in local with the Neo4j desktop. We will cover both before that we see the examples I will show you this on this tutorial. So you can just go to the Neo4j and go to, well, I install it in Windows, you can install it in Linux, you can install it the client, what is in Neo4j desktop, and also in macOS. Once you install it, you will just need to fill up a form, and you will get a license to, it's free, don't worry, it's free, a license to just activate your desktop. Once you have your desktop installed, you will get something like this, Neo4j desktop, just the latest version. It comes with a database by default, Mobis DBMS. You can I recommend you to install a new database to you to play, but in any case, you can install this as many times as you want. Just you need to keep the key that they provide during the installation and registration process. Once you install the plugin, once you install the client, you just need to create a new database, as I did here. You just click in Add and create with a name as a password a new database. Once you had this done, as I did here, I named the database testing. You just click here and go to settings. You can review here the configuration. You are familiar with Postgres or Oracle. You might find this is pretty similar. It's just the configuration of the database. And then on again, once you have this here, you can go. You will see here on the top the database. You can click here and go to settings and in. Oh, sorry. No settings is just click on the database and you will see the main information, how to connect to the database in local, the ports are available. I will explain you now what is what. And also, very important, go to plugins and install the APOC and Grad Data Science Library. This is very very important. This is just connecting with the kind of things that we are gonna do in these tutorials. We will use APOC. APOC is a set of procedures that just set prepare to work with Neo4j. It's not only data science, you have data manipulation or NLP, a set of 450 procedures. You can go to the GitHub and take a look what is included here. It's also developed by this guy. And yeah, you can take a look what we have here. Yeah. Again, a number of procedures for many purposes, and we will use it then under the hood. Also, the Grad Data Science Library is a number of that is developed by Neo4j. This is a number of data science algorithms that you can use inside Neo4j, like no similarity or and many others. You have here the documentation. So, by the way, Neo4j is developed in Java. We have interfaces in other languages, but the main language and the language that in which is developed the tool is Java. But well, usually, well, mostly I use the Python client. It's you don't need to, unless that you want to extension of the functionalities of the database, you will not need to use Java. But in some cases, it's good to know how you can extend some of the functionalities, as for example, is done with the Apoc library. Again, these two libraries will be necessary, not for today, because just today we are going just to install it and use it with LangChain, but in future tutorials, we will cover all the functionalities of the data science library, which is quite interesting, very interesting way to approach and to model different problems with the graph databases. And well, we will use it in other occasions. Okay. So you have all the information here. Also, you can use instead to use the desktop, you can use the sandbox. You just go to the login, and once you register with your user, your password, and well, there is some details that you have to fill in the registration. You get an instance ready to go with everything. You just need to use the flavor. I recommend you again to use the Graph Data Science version, where you had already installed Apoc and the Graph Data Science library. You can play around with the other two. I recommend you as well to use the sandbox if you are doing some training. There is different courses that are free of charge. You can cover them. They explain Cypher, they explain the library, they explain how to do queries, how to load data. Many things is very well documented as well, Neo4j. So and if you want to do something with it, I recommend you really to do it with the sandbox and use this version, because you have everything installed and ready to go. Once you install that, you will get how to say an account. Usually it's 3 days, but you can extend this for 10 days maximum, and you have here, well, all the details to connect to the database, and also in the different flavors of languages that you can use to connect to the database. For my case, I use Neo4j. You have the driver, Neo4j driver. You see here how to connect. The integration in between LangChain and Neo4j is done with this driver, but everything is wrapped in a class that we had imported from LangChain community, that is Neo4j Graph. So here, just we are going to use and make a very simple example, because we have also a class to just query the database. We will look a little bit the database. The database, once you have installed it, is simply like that. Let me just 1 second. Okay. So database is, well, you are familiar with a conventional structured database. This is slightly different. Here we have the records, and also we have relations, nodes. If you can make the simile of nodes to rows in a table, and relations. We have here 4 different tables: genre, movie, and person, and we have also relations. Relations is Probably you can make the simile that is the connection, the relations in between two tables, in between the two indexes is a little bit more complex, because a relation is, as you can see here, how you connect different tables with a relation name, and this relation also can have different attributes, no? You had records in your tables. The tables here are genre, movie, and person, and you have relations with each, the connections in between different tables. The number of connections, the direction of connections, how many connections, this had in theory no limits. And you can define as much as relation as you want, and then can have a meaning. One of the advantages I had is that you can set up, you can model a problem in a simple manner, probably more close to what a human being should do, because it's, in some cases it's very difficult to define especially relationships in between nodes in a tabula manner. So if you doing like this, is quite easy to understand and visualize how the different tables and the different records, like here person, movie, and gen are connecting, and what are the kind of relations, no? You can see here that there is a direction in between the different nodes, and every node had their own connections to other nodes and to other and with different relations at the end. Here we don't see attributes in this dataset, but you can set up as well attributes per relations, which allow you at the end to granularly and in detail set up or define the different relationships, model very granularly your problem in first of all a visual manner, and allow you to do very simple how to connect different tables from different records and set up in between them different relationships. To do this the same with a tabular database is really much more complicated, and one of the advantages as well that later you can export single nodes and transform them into, for example, embeddings, same way that we do with text, for example, or with tokens, creating embeddings. And once you export one of these nodes to an embedding, is exporting as well all the relationships and attributes that had not only at node level, also at relationship level, which gives you the ability to define not only what is a sample in your table, is also how it's connected with other table. Again, to do this with a tabular database like Oracle or MySQL or Postgres is really difficult, and also, as I said, it's practically impossible to embed on a single vector not only the attributes of your record, also the relationships that this record has with other records in the same table or with records in other tables. We will cover all this stuff in the videos I'm preparing about Neo4j and the GDS plugin. But today, again, we will just look at the relationship with LangChain. Okay, with LangChain, we just import load into memory the keys and the connection. Here, as you may see, we connect to the table. Two important nodes here. First of all, to work with a Neo4j database, mostly with all the GRAD database, we will use a language which is Cypher. Cypher is like a SQL language to query, to load data, to update, to delete data in a GRAD database. Is you can consider as similar to a SQL language, but prepare to work with nodes and relationships, which is how to say the main components of the GRAD databases. Also, to connect to the GRAD database, in this case Neo4j use a proprietary protocol which is Vault. Vault is a TCP/IP connection protocol which work in this specific port, and this is only to prepare and to connect to a Neo4j database. If you are working with LangChain, we had in LangChain community a specific class to just connect to the database, and it's just a client is working in on top of Neo4j driver, and essentially you just create the Neo4j graph connection and you can interact directly with that. For that you need the URI. If you are working with the sandbox, you can take the details from the connection page. You can take just here, instead you can see here they are pretty standard, all these how to say username and password are how to say created per connection, so don't worry if somebody can copy, because it's going to be destroyed after the video. And here you are working with the local, it's exactly the same. You have your URI, username and password. You import here the password from LangChain, and here what we are doing is just taking this CSV file, which is the some information, and we load it and created the GRAD database that you see here. This GRAD database contains three different tables and some relationships in between the tables. You see here the tables are genres, movie and person, and the relationships are acted in, directed, and in genre. There is also some property keys. These property keys are related to, in this case, to nodes. And then again, there is also properties that are related to relationships. But again, don't worry about that. We will cover this in the specific videos about that. Here, just we get some information from the table, just when you are connected with the client, and here just we are working with the specific class of the LangChain Chains, GRAD Cipher QA Querying. This class is not only to connect to Neo4j, this is to connect to one of the multiple graph databases that are available and integrated with Neo4j. You have a list here on the documentation I provide you in the notebook, and once you we just here connect to the LLM, we create a chain from this class, we pass the graph, we pass the LLM, and we just make a query. What is doing essentially this query? You see here on the details we are just executing a query in Neo4j. This is pretty similar as well in the other database, which you can just execute the query here and you will see what we are doing, and then this return, for example, here we are asking the movie Casino, probably you know, and return me at the end the actor name of the actors are acting in, so that are in the that had a relationship acting in, So we take note at for person. Person is the class, is the table person. The movie is the table movie. So it has to be a relationship acting in. You have it here. And what I want is return me all the persons that you had in the table person that had a relationship acted in with the movie casino, and you return me just simply the actor name. And this is exactly what you return here, and it's exactly what the class is doing. It's just executing a cipher query to the Neo4j database in this case, and the return is this information. Is you can do exactly the same with the Python client, and the query return is used by the LLM to build the answer. The case of casino includes Sharon Stone, Joe Pesci, James Woods, and Robert De Niro. If you watch the movie, it's exactly that. Here I just make another similar query, but with a validation, cipher validation, which exactly means is that the check first of all that the cipher query is correctly done, and after that execute the query on top of the database. But it's the same query. And that's all. We will look at this in a little bit more detail and a little bit more complicated example. I just wanted to cover first of all how to install Neo4j with this for people who is not familiar with this technology. It can be a little bit more complicated if they never work with that. And for the rest, you see, we are just scratching the surface, because this is a quite extensive, a quite complex topic. And we will make another video just launching Neo4j integration, and then on in other videos we will just cover as well the GRAT GDS plugin, GRAT Data Science plugin of Neo4j. And that's all. I hope you like it, you enjoy, and you find it informative and useful for your work. And as I say, usually, if you like the video, just give me a like and subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. Thank you very much.